Welcome back to Paul's Tech News. It is finally, officially summer 2024, my friends. So lube up those sunscreen bottles and get ready to slather yourselves in a modest esplugement of PC hardware news from the past, say, week or so. Side effects may include hazy euphoria and priapism. And it looks like I have returned just in time too, because some of this week's stories are difficult to stomach. Bowel-shaking reports about AMD's latest deception, NVIDIA giving us all a turn by taking its rightful place as the ruler of the known universe, and ASUS cleaning up the shit stain left by their RMA department, while Steve looks on. He likes to watch. And hopefully so do you. It's time for Tech News.
Excellent!
Today's video is brought to you by Thermaltake's EX series fans, featuring magnetic force connectors that can daisy chain fans together to simplify installation and cable management. CT120 EX fans feature solid all-around performance and a touch of tasteful RGB lighting. The SWAFAN EX series revolutionized case fans by adding swappable fan blades, and the TUFFAN EX Pro series sports best-in-class high static pressure for use with radiators and an aggressive all-black design. And all of them feature larger magnetic force connectors for easy wiring. For more on the EX series fans from Thermaltake, click the sponsor link in the video description. AMD has been breached, or so it would appear as rumblings on the dark web Tuesday about a trove of data being exfiltrated from AMD servers quickly made their way onto the less dark web, prompting AMD to make a public statement that they are looking into the situation and working closely with law enforcement officials and a third-party hosting partner to investigate the claim and the significance of the data. As if to salt the wound, the hacker allegedly responsible for the breach is known as Intel Broker, and true to their name, they have apparently stolen from AMD and are attempting to sell the goods for a profit. The data in question is truly information-packed as well, and might include detailed specs of upcoming products, property files, ROMs, firmware, internal communications, source code, financial records, and comprehensive employee information, names, user IDs, job roles, phone numbers, and email addresses. Samples of stolen data posted to breach forums include screenshots of AMD's internal systems, so the situation is quite serious for AMD and ongoing. Time will tell if Intel Broker finds a buyer, which I guess would make them Intel richer, or if the data ever goes public. But one thing I can say for sure is AMD totally deserves this. Why? Because they lied to us. In a very dumb way too, as revealed by Hardware Unboxed this week, who investigated AMD's performance claims for the upcoming Ryzen 5800 XT and 5900 XT CPUs, which were announced earlier this month at Computex. And comeuppance is due, it would seem, as these unlooked-for AM4 CPUs are based on Zen 3 architecture, which has pretty well-established performance characteristics, and it certainly cannot keep up with Intel's 13th Gen CPUs in CPU limited gaming tests. So, AMD tested with an underpowered RX 6600 video card, creating a GPU bottleneck, and made graphs like these, indicating that the 5900 XT is on par or 4% better than a 13700K. So Steve did what Steve does and tested, both with an RX 6600 and a 7900 XT, and found that even AMD's RX 6600 numbers are straight up wrong. And it's just frustrating, because why, AMD? Why even do this? No one cared about the 5900 XT and 5800 XT, but now there is needless scandal. You should know someone in the community is going to call you out on clear misrepresentations like these. It was a commenter in the Hardware Unboxed Computex livestream who originally pointed out the RX 6600 listed in the presentation footnotes, and more intense scrutiny naturally followed. It's a fundamental principle for PC enthusiasts. Benchmarking, that you can take the same hardware and identical test conditions, and if you do it right, your results will be consistent every time. It is the one small constant that we can rely on in this world of chaos and disorder, which is why we cling to it so very desperately. And when you try to sneak this kind of garbage past, you take that away from us. You destroy that balance and bring shame and dishonor to your entire company. You know what? This shit wouldn't have flown when Bobby Hacks was marketing director. Now he's at Intel. Well played, Intel. You win this round. Speaking of salting AMD's wounds, NVIDIA achieved a notable high water mark this week, for their stock price at least, $140.76 on Thursday, making Team Green the most valuable company in the world. By market cap, of course, peaking at $3.44 trillion. From my understanding, this now makes all of our video cards worth 2 to 3 times their original value, so congratulations everyone. On paper at least, we are all richer and more powerful than ever before. Of course, NVIDIA stock then plummeted later Thursday and Friday, causing them to lose more than $277 billion in value, so maybe don't sell your GPUs just yet. Hold, guys. Hold. Speaking of holding things, Gamers Nexus has been holding ASUS accountable for their poor RMA service, which seems to have culminated last week when Steve was seen performing a full frontal assault on ASUS staff at Computex in Taipei, and then gruesomely, but professionally, chewing up and discarding lesser PR reps and marketing directors until he scored a face-to-face meeting with this guy, also named Steven, the global head of ASUS customer service, who is so important he reports to the CEO and lives inside a small laptop computer. Thankfully, Steven's bloviating C-suite speak was interrupted at times by Peggy, an enthusiastic CS quality manager who also has enough authority to make some definitive statements about ASUS response. Oh, and Sasha was there too. After a lengthy and often awkward meeting, Steve succeeded in his goal of getting ASUS to commit to a range of improvements to their RMA service. And they made those commitments in writing. This includes a dedicated email address, executivecare@asus.com, created specifically to reprocess old RMAs that might have been rejected erroneously, as well as options to refund labor, repair charges, and shipping. There's a template to fill out if you have an old RMA that you want addressed by ASUS, and a further list of RMA policy updates on the Gamers Nexus webpage that is linked in the video's description. ASUS is even finally addressing the ROG Ally SD card issue, so that's that. All that's left is to wait and see how well they stick to their new policies. And we know that Gamers Nexus will be watching. Gamers Nexus is always watching. Okay, I don't mean to rush you, but it's time for tech briefs. Go! Last week, Igor's lab published what seemed to be great news. Intel's CPU stability woes were solved, and the root problem was just a pesky bug in the microcode algorithm, easily fixable with a BIOS update. But it turns out that's not quite true, and Intel, bless them, did the right thing by publicly stating that yes, that enhanced thermal velocity boost bug does exist and we are going to fix it with a BIOS update, but that's not quite the root cause of the instability issues. Our unlocked 13th and 14th gen CPUs can still have those problems. The search continues for a solution, which led to articles like this. Intel just can't catch a break. Speaking of scathing headlines, Adobe has seen many well-deserved ones recently, as cagey language in their updated terms of use seemed to indicate that they wanted full control to train their AI using any work their subscribers make using the Adobe Creative Cloud suite of products, like Photoshop and Premiere. Thankfully, after a bunch of people said, "Hell no," Adobe has updated the terms and will not be doing that, so all is forgiven, right guys? Well, perhaps not. Now the US government is suing Adobe as well for their simple customer-friendly practice of making their services confusingly difficult to cancel and threatening cancellation fees in the hundreds of dollars range that don't actually exist when people do try to cancel. Nice, Adobe. I sure am glad that we use Premiere here for Paul's hardware videos. I swear, Joe, if they f*** up 5 or 6 more times, we're switching to Resolve. I promise. Now clearly when AMD launched the Ryzen 8000 series of desktop APUs and I complained about the name being dumb, it depressed sales in the long term, which means I can take full credit for these new sales that just kicked off. The 8700G is now $30 cheaper at $299. The 8600G is also $30 cheaper, now $199. And the 8500G, even though it kinda sucks, is now $20 off at $159, making it the cheapest AM5 CPU that you can get now. And you know, since it's an APU, not a bad option for a starter build with a plan to upgrade to a better CPU and discrete GPU down the line. I'll link all three of these in the video's description. Finally, the YouTube ad war continueth, with our video overlord now experimenting with server-side ad injection, adding the ad directly into the video stream itself, which is just abominable. That's like how we do it. Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware Store on paulshardware.net.
This new method screws with timestamps used by current ad blockers, and who knows what it will do to user-provided timestamps in the future as well. VPN users and even the enlightened devotees of Firefox have also had difficulties this week, but Firefox still remains the best choice for those who do not want to cave to almighty Google's demands. So stay strong, my friends, and there you have it, tech news for the week. And if you liked it, click that like button or leave me a comment down below. While you're down there, all the articles I talked about today are linked in the video's description if you're interested. And you can also check out my store at paulshardware.net for high-quality merchandise, t-shirts, hoodies, beer sets, and more. Subscribing to my channel is always a good call, too. Thanks again, everyone. It's good to be back, and we'll see you next week.